Hey everybody, it's Christy with Christy called Artistry. Thank you for joining me tonight. Thank you to all of my subscribers. If you haven't subscribed, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of my videos. And I believe at the end of my video is also a playlist if you'd like to see some of my other videos. Before we start tonight's pour, I wanted to show you the dry results of my green tree. I love my tree. I think it looks really cool. So here is the dried results of our abstract green tree. And I liked how that came out. It was so much fun that I decided that I did want to do a blues, pinks, and purples version of them. But I'm going to do them on smaller canvases. So tonight I'm going to do a blue one on a 14 by 11. They are going to be vertical. And I'm going to do the blues tonight. So I'm going to get the canvas ready, bring you down, and we'll get started for tonight. So I'll be right back. So here is our color palette for this evening. As you can see, it's all blues. I've got my Academy Acrylic Prussian Blue, my Academy Acrylic Process Cyan, I have my Deco Art Sapphire, that'll give us some shimmer. I have my Academy Acrylic Permanent Blue Light, and I also have my Deco Art Extreme Sheen Sky Blue Topaz. These two will give us some of the shimmer like we had with the Green Pearl and, the Green Pearl? I thought there was another green that had a little bit of shimmer in it, but I can't remember what it was. So, before we start, I did want to mention, if there are any of the paintings from previous videos that I have not shown you guys the results of yet, please let me know in the comments and I will show the results. I'm kind of behind with sealing them, and I don't recall offhand which ones I've shown you that are dry and which ones I haven't yet. So if there's one that you like the video but we never saw the final result of it, let me know and I'll put it on another video. Okay, so we're gonna do our white. If I can get the lid off, we are. Oh my goodness. All right. I cracked it. That wasn't good. But I got it out. Okay. I have to watch out for that. So again, we're gonna do similar to what we did on our last painting. I'm going to kind of give myself an outline for my tree. I think I just found the chip. And I kind of want this one a bit thinner. Oops. Oh, that's not working out as well as it did on that bigger canvas, is it? Okay, so we're gonna just put that on there. And I need my spatula. White in here, and in here, and take out, oh, I thought the little piece was in there. Oh, must be still in my paint. That's not going to be good. Okay, so let's smooth this out so we get our nice white area that we want. And so that we can see where our tree is going to go. Was that it? I thought I saw a little chip. Like that. We may have to make that a little bit wider, but for now let's start a little thinner. Oops. Okay. Scoop some of that up so we don't waste it. This side looks great. This side is just not cooperating. I need a little bit more white on this side. I'm trying to smooth this with my left hand. That is fun. There we go. Get this to push over the edge. Now, if you did not like the green, I'm calling it a tree, tree painting. It is a very abstract tree. Let me know in the comments. What didn't you like about it? Was it the colors? Was it the fact that I call it a tree? What don't you like about it? And then if you did like it, tell me what you liked about it. Do you like the fact that it's so abstract? Do you like the colors? You know, give me a little hint as to what worked and what didn't. All right. Paper towel to put my spatula on. And I'm gonna clean up a little of that. I want a nice clear area like we had. Now, if you noticed on the other one, I did do some additional things to that one to make it, like I said, look more like a tree. Some branches and some roots and things like that. But I didn't want to overdo it because, again, the point is that it's supposed to be an abstract tree. And that is how I saw it. So I wanted to make it what I saw. Okay, I think we're good. So I'm gonna start with Prussian Blue. And this is my Academy Acrylic Prussian. And I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm just going to add the colors as I feel they should be. Gotta have some dark because that's where our roots and our branches are gonna start from. And then we need the accents. So we're gonna put in the cyan, because I like this color. We are going to use some of the Extreme Sheens because I want some shimmer. Again, this is my Extreme Sheen Sapphire. So, next we're gonna lighten it up with some permanent blue light. We can keep the nozzle open long enough. Just like so. Now, and then we'll put in the Extreme Sheen Sky Blue Topaz again for some shimmer and some lighter accents. Put more up here than down there. Okay, now looking at this, and I feel like I need just a little more of the dark Prussian in here. Just a little bit. I like that. Okay, that looks good. Let's now torch the bubbles. Now I'm not only torching the bubbles, I'm also trying to get the metallics and the pearls, the extreme sheens, to pop up some cells, because I would really like to see some cells. Okay, so I love these colors. These colors are so pretty. Okay, I'm not going to use the spatula. I am going to blow it out like I did last night. Oh my god, I always say last night and it's like 3 days from now. Okay, I'm going to use the small dryer because it has the small nozzle. Okay, and I should be able to still get it here without spreading this out too far. All right, here we go. that's better. As you can see, I'm trying to blow out the darker of the blue in order to get my roots to be entangled and my branches to come out. And I'm gonna have to help these out a little bit. And how I do this is I can take something like this and take the darkest color and then drag through it to kind of get that dark color to go through, or to at least appear as if it's going through to get my branches. And I can do that the same way if I'm trying to entangle my roots. So I can make my roots go all over the place just by dragging through the paint and giving these lights and darks like so. And then when that dries, you'll see all these little roots come popping out. I'm going off the canvas and stuff. So I'm just going to encourage some more. These to come out a little bit farther, like so, so that they kind of entangle, like so. Tricky part is getting the color so that you can actually see it through the other colors and so that it will stay. So I'm just sort of adding my branches on here and inside here so that when this dries you'll be able to more easily see the tree that I'm trying to create. I love trees. So anytime I can create a tree out of something, I'm going to do it because I just really like trees. Oh, I like that. That's looking good. So just adding little branches and details. Okay, so now here is sort of my middle of my tree. This is my dark roots, and we've got the tree all up in here, and it's beautiful. I know I have to fix that side, but I'm just looking at the entanglement down here. It looks pretty good. I see a few spots where I can keep in mind too, it's really hard to make bark in wet, you know, wet loose paint like this. Okay, I like that, I like that. So again, another beautiful abstract tree. Okay, I am going to just tap along the edges here to get the paint to come down. This little spot here, really, I think I need to bring that down. There we go. That looks nice. Okay. And I'm going to come over there and check that side. We've got coverage here. We've got coverage here. A little bit dripping down. Good. I have a spot I want to clean up right here. Like so. Okay. Then I'm going to let this settle a little bit, and then I'm going to look at it again and see if I need to add anything else. But I'm going to grab the camera, bring you down, and show you this lovely little tree. I'll be right back. Okay, so today we did a blue tree. Like I said, these are very abstract trees. So I'm going to show you the whole thing. And I think this needs to be a little bit wider, so I may work on that a little bit. It seems like it's going choo-choo. So I'll fix that. But otherwise, I think it's cute. Came out really nice. So I am gonna fix the center. I want it to be a little bit thicker. And other than that, let me take you down so you can see our roots and our branches. So here, if you look, you can see all the entanglement of the roots in here. And then when you go up here, you can see all the branches coming out. And I like making these as abstract as this, because trees, if you go look at a tree, they're not perfect. They're different, every one of them. They're all abstract. And I think these are really cool. So, until my next video, thank you for watching. And please, like I said, if you have any comments, please put them in the comments, and I do respond to them. And until my next video, please take care of yourselves and take care of each other. Bye.